One of Japan's most active volcanoes is a gray-colored volcanic cone which rises 1,500 meters above the surrounding landscape. Known as Mount Asama, this complex once produced an eruption so large that it emitted more than 6 million metric tons of sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere that it created an aerosol layer around the planet which blocked a double-digit percentage of sunlight. This was sufficient enough to cause a severe famine in much of Europe, while in Japan, similarly destructive effects also occurred. The eruption which was just described occurred in 1108, representing one of Japan's largest to occur in the last 2,500 years, and covered many of what at the time were farmers' fields and more than a meter thick of ash, even in some spots 15 kilometers away from the volcano. Then again, in 1783, another planetary eruption occurred, destroying many nearby villages with heavy ashfall and some pyroclastic flows, in addition to creating a tall, blocky andesite lava flow which crept across the landscape to a distance of 6 kilometers north of Asama's summit. Luckily, these larger-scale events are fairly uncommon at this volcano, as during the Holocene epoch, eruptions from Asama of a similar magnitude to what occurred during 1108 and 1783 have only occurred about once every 1,200 years on average. However, many far smaller explosive eruptions have occurred since then via the Kamayama cone at the complex's peak, which has two large craters, the last eruption of which occurred in 2019. Yet, apart from occasional large explosive eruptions, Mount Asama also has a number of fascinating qualities, such as a horseshoe-shaped collapse scar formed when much of the volcano collapsed 24,000 years ago, or the fact that Mount Asama has occasionally erupted outside of its main cone through flank lava domes up to 10 kilometers from its summit. Like many other volcanoes on northern Honshu and Hokkaido, Mount Asama exists due to an offshore tectonic plate collision where the Pacific plate is subducting underneath the Okhotsk plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards until it occasionally reaches the surface and erupts, forming a chain of volcanoes. Despite its name, Mount Asama does not merely encompass the peak which it is named after. Rather, it also includes two older volcanic peaks and a scattered assortment of lava domes. This complex as a whole has been intermittently erupting since approximately 92,200 years ago when its first major VEI-4 explosive eruption occurred. Through subsequent eruptions over a time span of 68,000 years, which are mostly Vulcanian in nature, overlapping masses of andesite lava and ash built a stratocone which reached a height of 2,700 meters taller than the modern Asama volcano. However, during the latter half of this period, repeated intrusions on the eastern half of the volcano occurred, causing that section of its edifice to turn shades of red and yellow due to intense hydrothermal alteration. Eventually, this section of the volcano became too brittle, and the eastern half of the volcano, including its peak, collapsed to the east in a massive landslide, which triggered a planetary eruption. In the aftermath, two vents erupted, one constructed a lava dome while the other constructed a dacite dome complex which is now buried by younger eruptive products. Once this became inactive, then the modern Kamayama cone began to grow, primarily being built out of andesite composition ash through explosive eruptions but also occasional andesite lava flows. A complex larger crater on the summit measures 1,250 meters across, which the inner crater lies within, with the larger crater likely forming through repeated Plinian eruptions. During historical times, this volcano has erupted more than 100 separate times, with only three of the group being fairly large and the rest being much smaller. Interestingly, these eruptions largely occur in a pattern. Much like the Taal volcano in the Philippines, this volcano produces a cluster of eruptions which occur about every other year for a period of time before not erupting for several decades. It is uncertain which of these two phases we are currently in, although Asama last erupted in 2019. These frequent eruptions have, for the most part, been relatively small, consisting of phreatic eruptions with minor ashfall and Vulcanian eruptions which often eject incandescent lava while also occasionally producing pyroclastic flows. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Jin's Shinkei for increasing their Patreon tier on this channel's Patreon page.